All right, let's take a look at the same example we just used and did the ANOVA on. Only this time I want to take the nonparametric approach, which is saying I had an issue with the assumptions. Now, here's the way it typically works. You go start off thinking in terms of the null hypothesis being group 1 mean is equal to the group 2 mean, which is equal to the group 3 mean. The alternative will be at least one of these groups is not equal. Alpha 0.05. We do our normality assumptions. We take a look at the normal plots, and we find out that there's a violation. So if there is a violation of assumptions, such as the normality, and actually you can use this if there's a normality assumption violation or a similar variance of assumption violation. If you have dependent groups, forget it, it's all over. There's nothing that we do at this level, of course, with dependent groups as such. So this is only going to work if you have a violation of your normality assumption or a violation of your similar variances assumptions. Now, we can complete a test that's known as, I have it written up right there, the Kruskal-Wallis test. The Kruskal-Wallis test is actually based on the ranks of the data. We've seen this before. The Wilcoxon rank sum was based on the ranks of the data. It's very common to work with nonparametric techniques that are based on the ranks of the data. So Wilcoxon rank sum, Spearman's correlation, Pearson's correlation was based on the data. If you saw curvature in the data, then you went to monotonic curvature, then you switched to Spearman's. Spearman's correlation is really essentially no more than Pearson's correlation is computed on the ranks. It's very common to use the ranks as a nonparametric technique. So when I switch to the Kruskal-Wallis, I'm going to restate my null alternative hypothesis. I'll say theta from group 1 equals theta from group 2 equals theta from group 3. And the alternative will be, again, at least one of these groups is not equal. Somebody's different from the rest. Or it could be they're all three different, but at least one is different. Alpha, I'll stay with 0.5. There's no reason to change it now. I did not do the normal plots here because I did them earlier. If you didn't do them, if you just jumped to this presentation, you got to go back and look at it, or you have the data there. Right there, pause the presentation, enter the data, and look at the normal plots. And you'll see what I mean when I say I'm not too comfortable with them being normal. Okay, now I'm just going to switch to my calculator program, and the program is listed as KW test. Kruskal-Wallis. Run it, and it asks you, how many data sets do you have? How many lists? I have three of them. Where are they? Well, list 1's in L1. List 2 is in L2. List 3 is in L3. And that's it. It's going to tell you it's calculating. It's going to do its magic, and there it is. It uses a test statistic of H, and there's the p-value. So I'm going to jot that down. My test statistic is 6.7697, which I really don't use that much. Actually, I won't use it at all. What I'm really interested in is the p-value. And I'm going to jot that down on the computer here. And there they are. There's the H test statistic, which is I personally won't use it too much. It's like the t-test has a t-test statistic in it. The z-test has a z. The common notation for the test statistic in the Kruskal-Wallis is an h. The p-value is really what I'm interested in here, 0.0339. Now, compare that with my alpha of 0.05. This is suggesting that we reject the null hypothesis, reject h-naught. Then we did the ANOVA, we said fail to reject. Now we're doing, no, we didn't. We did reject. I forgot. Yeah, we did reject. So it said somebody's different. It was 0.02, if I remember correctly. So we rejected both times. Now the question is, which is bigger? We're not going to be doing a multiple comparison test as such in a nonparametric technique. At this level, of course, just simply eyeball and say, hey, it looks like that one probably is. Knowing now that there is a statistical difference, is if there's one that clearly jumps out from the group, it's reasonable to say, yeah, that must be it. In a much more advanced type of course, you can get down to nitty-gritty and try to identify for certain which one is truly different, or if they're all different. Okay, in terms of Kruskal-Wallis, that's it. It's that simple. You have a violation of your assumptions for ANOVA, the assumptions being the normality assumption or the similar variance assumption. So you switch to a null hypothesis that is centered or talked about, that's talking about comparing the medians. Run the Kruskal-Wallis test, take a look at the p-value, make a decision. That's it.